How were you able to finagle your way out of a ticket? 410-338-1098. Marianne, I think I heard you on the promo say you were never so crafty. Or you?
I think I've been pulled over
probably
twice.
Once.
Yeah, twice for a speeding ticket. I've gotten like three since the pandemic on those cameras, and I'm mad.
Can't talk. Well, I guess you could go to court and talk your way out, but it's not the same as having
it's
a trooper
evidence,
come up
to you. Yeah, but it's literally like 42 and a 30.
Yeah.
Which I never even know when it goes to. Anyway. The one time a guy pulled me over in Rochester, and I was just mad. Yeah. Because you see the guy walking up, you're like, well, there goes money. That's all I think is money. I don't have it. He's going to want it, for the ticket. And I just gave him everything and was pissed. And then later, I found out I kind of knew him.
Oh.
Some friends knew him.
Oh.
So it was handled.
Oh, hey, got handled.
But his thing was, she was real polite, like in real life, he said she was real nice. I'm like, that's funny. I thought I was being really like mad. But they're used to people swearing at them. And
so your level
being
of mad.
My mad was not their level of mad.
Justin in Columbia, Marshall in Frederick. We start, though, with Brian in York. Kirk and Marianne. What's up, Brian?
Not much. How are you guys doing today?
Doing good. So give us your what? How did you get out of a ticket so we can use yours?
All right. Well, both of us would have been getting a ticket, but I was the passenger in a friend's car. We had just left a friend's house in Aberdeen, Maryland. And a cop saw us not wearing her seatbelt.
Oh.
And she like kind of waved us over. We pulled her over. She got her stuff from us. About 35 seconds later, she came running back and said, something else came up, basically, threw us her IDs back and went to go make this other call. But when she went to go make this other call, she busted a U-turn. And when she busted the U-turn, she clipped the curb and blew out her tire.
Lady drivers, am I right?
She didn't get to make the call, and we got off scot-free.
That was a good night for you and a bad night for that officer or whatever.
That's so lucky.
Dude, it was the middle of the day. It was like 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
How embarrassing, though, to clip that curb and get a flat, and you're standing there or whatever.
Yeah.
Yep. Yep. It's like, well, so long.
Brian, appreciate you, buddy.
Yep, y'all have a good one.
You know it, man. Marshall and Fred Neck. What's up, Marshall?
Hey.
Hey.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I was heading home on I-270 and got pulled over for doing 75 and a 55.
Okay.
Not that bad.
Trooper came up and asked me if I knew why he pulled me over. I said he thought I was cute and wanted my number.
Is that what you said?
Yep.
And?
He kind of chuckled, took my information, came back, said, I'm going to let you off because you made me laugh.
Yeah.
Okay. And here's my number.
Call me crazy.
No, that happened on the second one.
Good for you.
It worked twice.
Are you gay?
No. Okay. No, the second one was the female.
Okay.
Okay.
You just speed around and ask people if they think
just
you're cute.
Constantly ask for people's numbers.
I can't use
like that. I've only tried it twice and it's worked both times.
That won't work
All right,
for me.
Noted.
Thanks, Marshall. You got to have the
He's
look.
He's like, now I have to date this guy for the next month to keep my ticket.
Justin, Columbia, what's up?
Hey. So a friend and I long ago decided to take a temp job down in Crofton. We lived in Columbia, and it took us to like 2 o'clock to work every day, 2 a.m. to work every day.
Yep.
But we would race home every day to see who we could get the fastest there. And one day in our little county in Howard County, a cop just happened to catch me at the border. And so I scrambled, like, oh, my God, how do I get out of this? And at that time, I had an inhaler in my car. So I was like, last-ditch effort. I show him the inhaler. Please, I got to take my mom to her inhaler. She's having an asthma attack.
Hey.
And he's like, oh, my God, do you need a police escort? You need help? I was like, no, I just need to get there. She'll be fine. He's like, okay, I'll just let you go now, but next time.
I need an inhaler.
Wow.
I got to get an inhaler. Well, that's a good one. Thanks,
Justin.
Get
mine. I've got
Thanks.
One.
Yeah.
I could just, fake it.